There are a number of different approaches to medical ethics, and it's important to recognize that no one specific approach or set of approaches will work for every scenario that we encounter. One of the most commonly known is something referred to as principlism. For those of you who have taken a bioethics course previously, you'll probably have heard of this approach. It looks at four main bioethical principles: autonomy, beneficence, non-maleficence, and justice. There's other ways of thinking about ethical issues as well, and we'll try and explore some of these as we go through the module. There's an approach called casuistry, where we compare an ethical issue to what we call a paradigm case, or a case that everyone can agree on. There's an approach called deontology, which is a rule-based approach. This sometimes applies in medicine when we think about rules like first do no harm and always tell the patient the truth. And then some people think the best approach is something called teleology, or consequentialism. Teleology looks at the outcome of an action to determine if it's morally right or wrong. One of the ways that I like to approach ethical issues is to think about what are the medical issues, what are the ethical issues, and how can we address each of those. I'll give you an example. A few years ago, I had a patient on the ward that had a PICC line for intravenous antibiotics for a spinal infection. Unfortunately, I removed the PICC line too early before her antibiotics were done. This was a mistake. What are the medical issues and what are the ethical issues? The medical issues are that the patient needs reinsertion of the PICC line to finish off her course of antibiotics. This is relatively straightforward. The overriding ethical issues could be considered as things like truth-telling and medical error. Once we identify the category of medical ethics, we can think about ways that we've resolved similar issues in the past or cases that we've read about where these have come into play. So for example, when it comes to truth-telling, the overriding ethical consideration would be always tell the patient the truth. There may be exceptions to this rule, and we have to consider whether they apply in this particular case. It's the same thing for medical error. The overriding ethical consideration would be to disclose the medical error to the patient and let them know what you're going to do to resolve it. Again, there may be situations where there are exceptions to this rule. In my particular case, it was relatively straightforward in terms of my actions. I told the patient that I had made a mistake and told her what I would do to correct that. However, in some situations, you may be afraid that your actions will lead to undesirable outcomes. This is why each case and scenario is different and has to be considered based on its own merits. No one approach will work for every single case.